So, dear colleagues, dear friends, it's my great pleasure on behalf of the Directorate to welcome all you on this conference of Joint Institute Association of Young Scientists and Specialists. And it's my pleasure to present you a report concerning strategic plan of the long-term development of the Joint Institute up to 2030 and further. Unfortunately, I was not ready to, I prepared my slides using the Russian language, and sorry for that. So I will speak English, but slides will be on Russian. So first of all, you should know that it was established a special international working group. It was established in 2017 by decision of Committee of Plenipotentiaries of the Joint Institute. And the goal of establishment of this group was to develop the long-term strategy for the GINR until 2030 and further, to develop scientific and institutional strategy. And you can see that the list of our editors of and members of this working group is very, very well-known scientists. Among them, more than a half of members are from abroad. You can see Luisa Cifarelli, Anna Dubnichkova, Sidney Galias, Hans Gutbrod, Marek Ijabik, Richard Lednitsky, Marek Levitovich, Denis Nadj, Yuri Aganisyan, Eliza Rabinovich, Michel Spiro, Horst Stocker, Ishak Tsiruya, Gennady Zinoviev. So they are all people from either our program advisory committees or different European and Euro-Asian committees and councils, international bodies for scientific strategies. And this team had been working for almost 3 years. So it was decided to subdivide our strategy by seven scientific directions. They are traditional for the Joint Institute. Some of them are traditional, some of them are new and developing one. You can see first is nuclear physics for low and medium energies. Second is particle physics plus neutrino. Number three is relativistic physics of heavy ions and spin physics. Number four is condensed matter and the neutron nuclear physics. Number five is theoretical physics. Number six is radio and astrobiology. And number seven is informational technologies and high power computer clusters. So these seven working subgroups were closely discussing and developing the sections of the strategy for more than 2 years. And scientific part of the strategy was presented at our scientific councils, International Scientific Council, and also at Committee of Plenipotentiaries at least twice, this year in June and last year in November in Hanoi, Vietnam, where we had a session of Committee of Plenipotentiaries. And basically the scientific strategy was approved. And today I very briefly will touch the main scientific vectors for development of those scientific directions. And second part of the strategy touches the development of the Institute itself as an international intergovernmental body with seven laboratories, university center, with institutes in member countries and many, many our international partners. So today I also will spend some time to describe what was discussed and proposed for the second part of the strategy. So the position paper of the strategy is the following. The strategy gives the coordinate system and principles of formulation of the next development program of the Joint Institute. You know that we have traditionally seven years development programs. First one was started in 2003, second one in 2009, the third one is in 2016, and next one will start on 2024. So this is about the development program, but the strategy is the document of the higher level of the larger scale strategy. The long-term strategy has to establish and formulate principles for new development program. That's why our task was to develop a document which will give impact to main indicators of scientific effectiveness and resultiveness of the Joint Institute, which will lead to strengthening and widening of member countries, and also to increase visibility of the Institute for Society, and of course to stimulate the flow of brains to the Institute, the flow of bright scientists and specialists with bright creative abilities. And of course, all these principles have to provide scientific, educational and innovation activity of the Joint Institute in accordance to the best and modern international standards. So the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research is the international intergovernmental organization created in 1956. Next year we will celebrate our 65th anniversary. And the main task for us is to keep and develop our main mission, which is science brings nations together. So our mission is to integrate the science, the human, and the world. And this document, the long-term strategy, is addressed to, first of all, our plenipotentiaries, then to international scientific society and the country where the Joint Institute is located, I mean Russian Federation. And also this long-term strategy has to touch and has to be accepted and acquired by the Institute personnel, by partners of the Joint Institute, and for different observers. Observers, I mean, not only those who want to become by observers, but also to those who look at our Institute and will monitor its activity and try to establish some kind of state of art in the international science. So on the left part of slide, you can see by our vision, six main pillars of the Institute, not pillars, but six main directions of the Institute development. They are international leadership in the science and fundamental basic research, in the niche where Institute can keep such leadership and develop it. Of course, Institute has to promote interests of the member countries and to develop partnership network to involve new member countries to the orbit of the Institute. Of course, Institute has to have in priority education and human resource development. The next one is to provide an international modern access to our scientific research infrastructure. Of course, we have to perform and we have to, we have to keep the modern methods for innovation and research. And one of the main vector of life of the Institute for at least for recent years is public relations and outreach of the research which we conduct in the Institute and to be useful for the society. When we start to compile this strategy, we indicated main challenges, so-called main risks and grand challenges, which is now a rather modern technique and rather modern practice. And it was created a special expert analytical group, which includes more than 20 members from the Institute. Mainly they are middle age, around 40-45 middle age scientists and researchers from the Institute. All laboratories are included into this group on the level of, say, deputy directors or scientific secretaries or active scientists and scientific leaders. And this group had been working since April of this year, and this group, with participation of the Central Directorate and directors of the lab, compiled this document which I present today. So what challenges and risks we see? First of all is losing of status of the member of elite scientific club. Then it's a crisis of how the society see the society and the state see the value of nuclear physics and particle physics, including also mega science installations. Of course, aging. Trend due to external factors to the distant and remote operation and to the brain drain because of universities and innovation companies. Next challenge for the Institute is not modern administrative management. It means disbalance of the personal cohorts, disbalance of the budget, non-concurrent salary system, and other barriers. The main challenge for us is to lose the status and the role of the intergovernmental international center and to become a national institute. And the last but not least challenge is the tendency to do science outside of Dubna, not because only of pandemic, but also due to concurrence with other scientific centers and due to the fact that pandemic problems, it becomes more difficult to cross the barriers between states. So the architecture of the strategy is given on the part of the right part of slide. You can see we propose to have six parts of the strategy. So the international governmental organization status, the human resource policy, scientific policy, social media management administrative management of the institute, and innovations, PR, and research. So our DNA of the institute, we think it is the problem thematic plan. So it's scientific program of the institute. So now I come to a very brief description of the scientific strategies and let's start from theoretical physics. Here you can see that several wide directions are included into the strategy to develop theory of fundamental interactions, theory of condensed state, nuclear physics, and modern mathematical physics. By the way, I think we can count the laboratory for theoretical physics, Bogolyubov laboratory, as the not only the biggest theoretical institute in the world, but also as a research infrastructure of our institute. So it's not only offices, it's not only personnel. It is an infrastructure, because the groups of theoreticians and group of talented physicists and theoreticians in this lab can support every scientific direction in the institute. And in this sense, it is not only supplied facility, but also a facility, I mean, Bogolyubov laboratory, also a facility which could create and generate new scientific directions and scientific projects to be realized by other laboratories. Next one is nuclear physics, and here main vectors are low energy nuclear physics, super heavy elements physics, neutron-rich exotic nuclear, nuclear astrophysics, nuclear chemistry and atomic physics of extremely strong Coulomb fields. Here it is planned to realize experimental program in the field of super heavy elements to continue development of the experimental facilities at fabrics of super heavy elements to construct in next 5-10 years specialized radiochemistry complex, and to continue experimental program with light exotic nucleus at modernized cyclotron U400M with new separator Akulina. And among the trends or future technological priorities, you can see we want to put attention to the development of new ICR source for 28 gigahertz to be able to generate uranium atoms with charge state up to, say, 40 plus something, and reconstruction of deep modernization of the U400 accelerator, and to construct a new experimental hall. The strategy for high energy physics and particle physics is given at this slide. Main column here is the NICA scientific program. We expect to to commission start configuration of the NICA in 2023. So by end of 2022, the civil construction and collider and detector phase zero has to be assembled and prepared for the experiments. And in 2023, beginning of 2023, we plan to start commissioning of the whole complex with heavy ion beam. It will be either gold or something around, I mean uranium or bismuth. And the scientific program for NICA is fixed in our main documents. You can see this is collision of heavy ions at square root of S from 4 to 11 GeV, and also collision of transversely and longitudinally polarized proton and deuteron beam. And also, we start discussions now about future development of the NICA complex after 2030 or 2035. For example, given a possibility to create an electron-ion collider on the base of NICA complex, also to some of option is to create merging bare uranium beams to investigate supercritical Coulomb fields. And another possible option to develop this project is to exchange superconducting magnets with high field ones and to get the possibility to accelerate proton beam up to 50 GeV and to use the Nika ring as this intense proton source. And concerning the physics of high energy physics, the goal of the institute is to participate in experiments in different accelerator world centers like CERN, Brookhaven, DESI, FAIR, GSI. The key factor is complementarity and two-way road. If we participate in those projects, they has to be also useful for us, and this participation and has to be pragmatic for us. Pragmatic participation in experiments such as NA61, COMPASS at SPS, ALICE at LHC STAR at RIG, they are very wealthy for the NICA physics program. And of course, strategically important, we see the participation of the Joint Institute at experiments at future electron ion collider in United States. Of course, we have to cooperate with CERN, Brookhaven, Fermilab, GANIL, Institute for Modern Physics in China, FAIR, DESI on the frontier accelerator technologies. So the strategy for particle physics and astrophysics, it is mainly hadron physics at ATLAS and CMS in CERN, and also neutrino physics. Here, the neutrino hierarchy experiments, mass measurement experiments, magnetic moment, and search for sterile neutrino, participation in radio physics neutrino program, neutrino-less double beta decay, and of course, construction and start of the physics program at Baikal GVD complex. Our key participation at Dune and at Nova Dune in UK and Juno in China, and potentially interesting for the Joint Institute could be our inclusion to the gravitational interferometers activity, which are now in the US and in Europe. Well, radiobiology is fundamental research for molecular cell and tissue and organisms of biological patterns, beam and nuclear therapy, astrobiology, and here our flagship activities are the radiation safety of long space missions and fundamental aspects of radioecology, and of course different applied research by the laboratory for radiation biology and laboratory for neutron physics. So condensed matter physics, the short-term perspectives are development and modernization of the IBR2 spectrometers. Already now we have good examples of increasing of effectiveness more than 10 times. And next goal is, the parallel goal is to commission the new iron source with design parameters. If you speak about the long-term perspectives, it is a neutron source, which will exchange IBR2 in middle of 2030s by so-called super booster Neptune. We call it New Dubna Neutron Source, DNS4. It will provide more short and more intense neutron pulses with the neutron intensity similar to European spallation source. It means that we could have here the experimental program with resolution which corresponds to the best spallation sources. And finally, the scientific strategy for information technologies is to creation and development of the IT ecosystem. And here, of course, we have to be a part of the world, of the global IT ecosystem, and to be a part of such global systems as GRID, but also and other scientific networks, but also for us of great importance such activities as development of data lake activities, machine learning, big data analytics, and of course the provision for the joint institute basic facilities for NICA, for super heavy elements, for reactor, for Baikal, provision of the best heterogeneous computer complex to store and analyze the scientific data information from our main facilities. So here is the summary of the scientific strategy. I already commented all of them. That's why I will not pay time to comment all you see on the slide. Just only three last points. They are innovation, fundamental research, and probably you already have heard that in next year we plan to develop, to design and then to construct innovation center for nuclear technologies, which will consist of two shoulders. One is nuclear medicine. It will use a cyclotron and microtron for research of new isotopes, families of isotopes, and for radiation stability of electronic components. And second shoulder will be superconducting cyclotron for proton beam therapy. And also, of course, high temperature superconductors and different detectors technologies for medicine, for safety and other things. Of course, we have to participate in national programs of the member countries. And of course, as I mentioned already, we have to participate in the global projects such as FCC, gravitational wave interferometers, big data global project, probably ILC, FAIR, and well, many others. So here is the matrix of GINER-K projects. Here you can see the timescale of realization of the all these activities and scientific directions up to 2040. So for next 20 years. Now I come to the next part of the strategy, which is about the development of the Joint Institute as an international intergovernmental scientific organization. So main goal is to provide fundamental basic research. We would like to pretend to be a leading international center and the moderator of the international scientific landscape. We will keep and develop traditional scientific directions such as theoretical physics, nuclear physics, particle and astrophysics, condensed matter, IT, but also will make a sense and will make a stress on new directions which are, well, existing and proven global trends. They are life science, artificial intelligence, quantum technologies, safe and green energetics. our main advantage is large scale, unique experimental facilities. They are now five, the Nika, the super heavy fabrics, and well, DRIPS facility in Fleurov laboratory, neutron reactor in Frank laboratory, the Baikal neutrino telescope in Djelepov laboratory, and heterogeneous information cluster in the laboratory for information technologies. The main wealth of the institute is people. That's why we have to pay great attention to the development of human resource and to make a lot of efforts for outreach. We have to discuss with our member countries and to develop mission-oriented science and to create an open innovation research space here in the Joint Institute. We have to pragmatically participate in external projects to be regularly expertized by external bodies like program advisory committees and scientific council. And of course, we have to widen our partnership network. So, as I mentioned already, our DNA, scientific DNA, is our problem thematical plan. We call it PTP. So it's a scientific program of the Joint Institute. We propose to formulate not only themes and projects, but also a term of collaborations in the next generation of PTP. We would like to keep the regular rotation of leaders of projects and collaboration and themes, and to evaluate resultiveness of the projects and teams. And the main, well, administrative issue is to harmonize the themes and projects with all resources. I mean, human resource, infrastructural resource, financial resource. Here you can see some modern indicators of the Joint Institute activity. So by 2020, we have 1,143 scientific workers, scientists, and almost 2,000, a bit more than 2,000 persons of engineers and specialists. So the total quantity of researchers, they are scientists and scientific engineers. They are almost 1,000 and a half. And one third of them, I mean, 521, are personnel not from the Russian Federation. So the proportion is 1-2-2, if we compare representatives of the Russian Federation and member countries. Institute generates in average every year around 1,500 publications. It's very good. It's very good indicator. It means that more than one and quarter per each researcher. We have 35 PhDs and more than 20 dissertations defended every year. We have very good part of defended candidates of science. There's almost 70%. Other indicators you can see as X and Y. It means that we are now still calculating and estimating these numbers. The big data of the institute, stored big data, now is almost 17 petabyte, but our goal is to be available to store more than 100 petabytes. Another interesting indicator is a time which is spent for one publication at such facilities as reactor. It is 18 days, and it is very good in comparison with European neutron sources, for example. So and others. So this set of indicators is set for monitoring the strategy which I present today to you. Well, next task is to optimize the administration of the institute, and here the goal for effectiveness are given on the left part of slide. You can see we have to minimize raw data, we have to speed up significantly the work with documentation, and of course the administrative system of the institute has to be bilingual at least. So English and Russian, they are official languages of the institute. Well, probably you know that we have not fast working a procurement service, and this is just as an indicator what we have to develop and what we have to speed up within next few years, several years, in order to be more effective than we are now. Concerning the human resources, you can see that our goal is to be more young. Now we have two peaks. One is around 35, next is around 65. But of course, the central weight has to be around 40-45. It's a green curve. It's our goal by 2030. We have to work on the gender balance. Now, if we speak about scientists, it is only 16% of female. But if we speak about total personnel of the institute, females are 33%. But I think we have to, Europe and Asia and all developed countries, all developed organizations, we have to keep the gender balance, and our goals for next 10 years are given below, you can see. So, of course, we have to have more working personnel from all member countries, not only from Russia. And the digital index of the organization has to be, index of digitalization has to be more than 80%. And finally, social media, we think it is very important issue to develop the integration culture or so-called institute and the personnel. The Joint Institute is our common house at the Volga River, and we have to work to create the space attractive for all member countries. If you speak about language, navigation, different social questions, we have to be more careful for the environment, including energy and natural safe, and to participate in different international initiatives. We have to keep and develop polyculture social media to support higher and medium school education, bilingual or trilingual. And of course, we have to have a modern and well prepared infrastructure of their working space, so offices, roads, buildings, etc. We start to monitor the statistics for the visits to Dubna and to the Joint Institute, not only of scientists but also of scholarships, schoolmates, sorry, and students, and other different visitors. I think that it is important also to monitor the number of families. If scientist comes to Dubna, if he comes with family, he will be more effective here. So, and of course, innovations, and as I mentioned already, we plan to design and create a so-called international inter-lab innovation center for life science, and the first stage of this center will be for radiation and nuclear medicine, as I mentioned already, but also, of course, technologies applied fundamental research and applied research for ecology, for big data, quantum technologies, etc., will be supported in the institute, and probably we will establish a foundation for support of innovations and to support startups of students and PhD here in the institute. Here you can see some statistics of partnership of the institute. It's a number of organizations collaborating with the joint institute. You can see almost 200 from Russia, more than 70 from US, 66 from Germany, 40 from France, etc. On the right part of slide, you can see employees from joint institute member states, including EU and total in states, and also some statistics for short-term visits in comparison from 2017 to 2019. And finally, I have to mention some concrete steps which we plan to perform in next several years, starting already from next year. As I mentioned already, we put our priority to human capacity of the institute. We think that research infrastructure had been developed and supported for last 10 or 15 years, and now we created an absolutely unique, large-scale, world-class research infrastructure, but somebody have to work on it. And of course, the institute has to pay great attention to outreach and innovations activity, but main vector, main priority for this 2020-2030 is human capacity. As I already showed on slides before, we expect that within next 10 years, the research personnel of the institute must be increased by at least 1,000 of people. So, and on the left slide, you can see the quark model, three quarks, infrastructure and research, outreach, innovation and human capacity. And you can see in between the strong interaction field and eight field carrier are given on right part of the slide. The first one is International Innovation Center, I already mentioned. So probably you know that I'm sure you know, we started the creation of the middle school in Dubna, which is Lyceum, named after Academician Kadyshevsky. It is already in the active phase of civil construction, and next September 2021, we plan to open officially this school. It will be for schoolmates from 5th class up to 11, and specialization of this lyceum will be physics, mathematics, biology, chemistry, and IT. And I'm sure that this object will be very important for all you, for your children, for your future children, and I'm sure that Association of Young Scientists and Specialists will play active role in the policy of this lyceum. Next bullet is Jinner High School in collaboration with Dubna University and universities from member countries, from Russia, from Czech, from Poland, from other countries. We plan to develop international IT school and international engineering school. Already for recent 2 years, every year we took about 20 students for international engineering school and about 20-25 students for international IT school. And we will support this activity and will develop it. Well, we discuss now very actively with large industry companies like Microsoft and Yandex and others to create so-called digital model of the joint institute, so-called digital dinner. It is the digital platform for all administrational activities and processes of the institute. I hope it will be created within next 2 years, mainly with the main role, with the leading role of our laboratory for information technologies, and probably it will be a product for our member countries. We plan to announce in next jubilee year to open a call for proposals for the Joint Institute Science Exhibition and Communication Hall. All you know about the Globe Center at CERN, and there is an idea to create something similar, but not similar, something our, something, well, special and unique for Dubna here on the Volga River bank. I hope that within 2 years, well, 2 or 3 years, this object will appear here in Dubna. The next thing is important, I'm sure, for all you. We have a plans to design and start civil construction of the new district here in the institute part of the city, between the Joint Institute Laboratory for Nuclear Problems Technical Ground and University. Of course, we have to pay attention to development of social programs, for pension program, medicine, pass gates, ecology, transport, etc. And here at this orange or light brown bullet is a, I would say, main not responsibility, but main role should come to the your association. And by the way, Nikolai Vaitishin and Sasha Verkheyev are members of this Joint Institute Analytical Expert Group, and they are responsible for this development of the strategy. And finally, there is a, well, not dream, but some plans to create here so-called scientific Davos, which we will call Dubna Science Diplomatic Club. The communication ground for different countries, different cultures, religions, etc. And hope it will be associated with the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research. So you can see it's a large and very ambitious program for all us. I'm sure that all you are part of this strategy and of this program, and I invite you to not be only a part of this, but to be an active player in the realization of all these plans. Thank you very much for your attention.